Name the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm going to read you something that I wrote today about St. Anthimus the Blind. He's a new ascetic of Cephalonia, and he's celebrated on September 4th on the church calendar, and he reposed in 1792. I read his life today and was quite inspired by the words that he said to his disciples before he died. We should take note of these words, and we should try to emulate him in some way. So I'm going to read because I wrote it, and it's just easier to do that. So I apologize if I'm not always looking at you, but I generate things all different ways, reading, writing, just speaking extemporaneously, etc. So our Holy Father Anthimus was blind with his earthly eyes, but he saw many heavenly visions. He was a great ascetic and a founder of monasteries and was on an errand on a ship when suddenly he said it was not God's will for him to conclude the errand, but to go back to his monastery to die. On returning to the monastery, he fell ill with jaundice and he made ready to fall asleep in the Lord. He called his spiritual children and told them that his end was near. Every word of what he says applies to us, whether we're monastics or not. My children, the hour has come for me to go where the Lord ordains. Death is a common lot of us all and nothing to be afraid of. It is important rather to do your best and to keep your promises and your monastic vows. The one thing necessary in this life is to please God and to save our souls. May God forgive us. We are poor sinners. We have the use of our earthly eyes, but our soul is darkened, so we see very little or nothing in the spiritual realm. We're not ascetics, we're full of sins, and we fear death, but we know not when it will come. And even with our fear of death, we live in many ways heedless lives, with very little prayer, and if we have a prayer room, it's too small and we don't even do it all the time. We must read the lives of holy ones of yore, and we must beg their intercessions, and we must try to follow them in some way. We cannot follow the exact details of their lives, but we can be more strict with ourselves. We can do more prostrations. We can come to services more frequently. We can certainly read the Psalter. We can struggle against our sins. We can take everything more seriously. We're without excuse, but fortunately, these holy ones intercede for us. And perhaps, even though we're weak, God will see that we are beset on all sides by heresy and by worldly filth and by distractions. Even among our hierarchs, some of our hierarchs, the spirit of Antichrist is showing its ugly horned head more boldly. So what are we to do? We are to do what we should have been doing all along. We are to pray. We are to fast correctly. We are to not make excuse for ourselves and come to the services. We're supposed to do more than just on Sunday morning and do more prostrations or begin to do them. We must be reading the Psalter and be reading the Gospels. If we immerse ourselves in the Psalter, the Gospels, the lives of the saints, and also, of course, have a robust rule of prayer, we will be like sheep that know the voice of the shepherd. We will be able to tell when a false shepherd is speaking with a secular mouth in compliance with the spirit of Antichrist. Let us poor ones try to obey the saint. The saint spoke of keeping monastic vows, but certainly our vows should not be much different than that of a monk. Our vows should be to love God with all our heart, soul, and mind, and all our strength, and our neighbors ourselves, just like a monk. Our vows should be to live ascetically and not frivolously, just like a monk. Our vows should be to fear God and follow his commandments, just like a monk. These are just the vows of baptism. We all have made them, at least implicitly. We should also make these vows explicitly. Let us not fear those who can kill the body or even constrain the body, but let us rather struggle today more, and also the rest of our lives, to fear him and to please him and to save our souls. Of course, we're in the midst of a terrible trial for people. Secular governments are trying to constrain us, and they're probably going to succeed. And then there are hierarchs that are collaborating with the secular government. May God forgive them. And there's a lot of fear, and there's a lot of anxiety, and we have loved ones that have problems, and we have so many things, and perhaps people will lose their jobs and everything else. Maybe all that stuff's going to happen, but we must live as Christians. So we got to take his words to heart, and we've got to struggle to follow the gospel. And if you're not praying very much, well, you know, you don't have a whole lot of chance. You really don't. And if you're not doing prostrations, well, you should do them, because prostrations are a very important part of ascetical prayer. Do them. Okay, you can tell me, I can't do a prostration because, well, my back hurts. Well, you can do something. You can get on your knees and pray. You can get on your knees and do a half prostration. You can stand instead of sit. You can do low bows. You can do something. Or you can say, well, you know, I can't do it. Well, no, you can't do it. If you say you can't do it, then you can't do it. But times are not going to get easier. They're going to get harder. We just had a proclamation by the Holy Eparchal Synod of the GOA, which was just complete secular nonsense. It was in the spirit of Antichrist. There's going to be more like that. There's going to be very few bishops and priests that actually support true piety. If you notice, all these proclamations that are made say nothing about the things that I'm saying, talking about in this video, like fasting and prayer and prostrations and such. It's all secular remedies. It's all follow the secular man. Well, the secular man is going straight to hell. Do you want to go with him? Let's follow instead St. Anthimus, who is not a secular man, who's a holy man, who's a spiritual man, even in this life he was. And we should struggle to follow the commandments, to please God, to live in a spiritual way. And when we have fears about what's going on, well, okay, we're human, or we're becoming human, I guess. And we have passions, but we must rise above those passions and have a better prayer life. That's very important. May God help you. May God save you. Don't give in to secular authorities. Don't give in to secular wisdom. Secular wisdom is an oxymoron. And if you see a hierarch that is touting secular wisdom without anything else, well, don't listen to him. May God help you. May God preserve you. Don't just talk about the news. Don't just rail against whatever's happening. Instead, get on your knees and pray and read the Psalter and read the Gospels and go to church a little bit more often and do all those things. Because I'll tell you, it might come a time when church is not so easy to come to. It might happen. It happened before. It'll happen again. So God bless you. God help you. And just follow the Christian way, like the saint talked about. May God bless you. May God help you in all things.